Welcome, welcome, welcome again, guys. Thank you so much for new subscribers. Thank you for watching videos. Thank you, guys. In this video here, I have an application that was made in .NET 0.5, and I'm going to show you guys how to upgrade it to the .NET 0.6. So let me show you guys. But this is the channel. If you haven't subscribed, don't forget to subscribe. Make sure you follow. And this is the application here. So about scheduling, as it was made with using .NET 0.5. So this here, I'm going to upgrade and I'll make it to .NET 0.6. So let me open the application actually here. So the application works. Let's go ahead and sign in. Make a sign in real fast so I can show you guys that it's working. So this application is about setting up appointments. You can add it, edit, you can do anything. So let's put down physical check. Just put down physical check. That's the title. Checking physical. Just going to put that. And the appointment is going to take 2 hours. So I'm going to go ahead and hit submit. Okay, so here's that. I can edit if I wanted to. Let's put them to. All right, so we know the application works. So right now, I'm going to show you guys the application. Give me a second. Let me open it up over here. All right, so the first thing in order to upgrade it, let me actually open the documentation too so we can read it as we go. All right, hold on. Sorry about that. I had way too many pages open. All right, so I had to close some of them. All right, so the first thing it says over here, the requirements here. It says to update. Oh, so the first thing you want to do is you want to go here. It said .NET 0.5. You can actually find it. You can actually read it. Go to Microsoft and to type in how to upgrade from .NET 5 to 6. So first thing you want to do is upgrade the target framework. So you want to change it to 6, and then it actually tells you that you have to upgrade all these packages. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to upgrade. We're going to change into 6.0. Oh, forgot the dot. So I'm going to change all these to 6.0. Compile. So I'm going to change that. This one here, you can leave it alone. All right, so this one too. So anything, all the packages that you see, the one you're using, if it's below 6.0, you want to change it to 6. If you're going from 5 to 6. All right, so I have all of them. So next thing, I'm going to go ahead and build the packages again and see if we do. Hopefully, we don't have any errors. So let's do that. I'm going to go ahead and rebuild the application. Okay, it did throw me an error. I think I have to upgrade the SQL too. So let me go ahead and do that. I'm going to change this one to 6. So whatever database you're using, I think you'll have to upgrade the package too. So let me go ahead and rebuild it again. Let me go ahead and control F5. All right, cool. So it works. Let me try to sign in again. All right, so I'm back at it again. Let me see if it's, all right, let me put down here. Let's put appointment would be blood work. Blood work. Checking. For physical. This is appointment for doctor's appointment. So let me go ahead and hit submit. Yeah, the doctor, that's me right there. All right, cool. So it's working, the application. So that's the first step. So you can do it like that. The other way you can actually do is go to tools, go to package manager, and you go actually here where it's all the packages, you can actually go updates. So this is all the ones that have been installed. You can actually select them and you can update them from here also. So I try that. I try this way, actually works too. So you see now they're saying 6.6.0. All right. So we go back to the documentation and it's right here. So that .NET 6.6, it uses a new hosting model. So if you take a look before if you take a look at the application, if you have like an old application, you want to update it to the .NET 6.6, .NET 6.7, you're going to notice on the older versions, it actually used to have the startup, and now the new one, it actually uses program. And here, it tells you, here, if it says the new .NET 6.6 minimal hosting model for ASP.NET Core apps requires only one file and a file lines of code. So it's faster, it's less code, it's better for you. So that's what I'm going to do. I am going to actually get rid of the startup, and I'm just going to keep the program. So what I'm going to do is I am going to go here. Go ahead and close this. Go ahead and close that right there. I'm going to go ahead and open program CS, this right here. And the first thing I want to do is I'm going to go ahead and comment all this out. All this right here. Go ahead and comment this out. Oh, wait, messed up. It was supposed to be all this. Let me go ahead and do that. I'm going to go ahead and comment all of it. That's the way it needs to go. There it is. So we're going to start with a new line over here. And here we're going to do var builder. And this one's going to be equal to web application. And we want to do create builder. And this one, we're going to wrap up arc like that. And the next thing I want to do is I'm going to comment here. I'm going to put down add services. This is where all your services are going to be. And we put down container. The next one I want to do is let me put down custom services. Okay, so let's see what else we got. And then we're going to need one for the pipeline with the HTTP request. So what we want to do is configure. We're going to do configure the HTTP. HTTP requests. This is where all their HTTP requests will go. Like that. And then let me see what else we need. Okay, so here what we're going to do is we're going to put them underneath the custom service. We're going to put down, we're going to create another variable. It's going to be called var app. And this one is going to be builder.built. Okay, like that. So let's go to the program. I'm sorry, startup. First thing I want to do is I'm gonna grab all these services. So in your application, depends what you have in your application. You can copy all of these, whatever's included inside your configure service, and you can transfer it. So I'm gonna do that right now. So these I am going to put them right where it says add services inside the container. So I'm going to put them right here. So, okay. So you're going to have a lot of these errors. Don't worry. So the first thing you want to do is because you created this variable called builder. So you want to do builder dot, and then you want to change it to services. So, and then I'm going to go ahead and control dot so I can go ahead and import this. So see the error went away. And of course, I want to import this one. Okay. And this one here is going to change. Going to change a bit. Let me see. Let me figure out why. Up here, I am going to put down builder like that. Configuration. Yeah, now see the arrow went away. Same thing over here. I'm going to do builder.services. See how it's the arrows are disappearing little by little. So I'm going to go ahead and do them all. All right, so I got them all over here. I got all my custom, all my services. Then I have one over here. It says custom service. Okay, so shoot, I forgot to do this one. Builder, the services. All right, cool. So now let's focus on the, let's focus over here on the HTTP pipeline real fast. Let me get it. All right, let me get it closer. So now let's go back again to the startup and let's go below here. So I'm going to do is I'm going to grab everything that's here. It says if. I'm going to grab it all of that right there. Let me go ahead and put it right below here. Ah, let me get rid of that. Okay, so that's that. Make sure there's no errors right now. Ah. Okay, so this one here is popping up there. So you want to do is app environment, right there. Just like that. Cool. All right, so everything, no more errors. The last thing I want to do is, okay, so the last thing I want to do is I'm going to go ahead and type in app.run here. All right, so let me go ahead and make sure all the errors you wanted. Oh, and also the last thing I want to do is get rid of, I don't know if you see all these dependencies, all these imports that I did from the previous one. So if you have some of those that you're not using, you can always take them out. But last thing, I want to go ahead and delete this right here. This is from .NET 4.5, no longer needed. And I am going to go ahead and delete this beautiful file, but we don't need you anymore, startup. I'm gonna go ahead and delete this one. Let me go ahead and hit F5 to build it again and see if we get the application to go. And if we did, that means we have succeeded the upgrading from .NET 0.5 to .NET 0.6. All right, just taking a little bit. All right, so we did it. We actually got the application to go. All right, so that is if you have a .NET 0.5, this is the perfect video to show you how to upgrade to .NET 0.6. So it's the application. Let me make sure it doesn't break. Make sure it still works. So let me go ahead and log in with my password. So it should still have the same data that I put in and the schedule. See, it still works. That I can actually delete it. See, it's gone. I'm going to go ahead and delete it. It's gone. So if I refresh it, yep, see, it's gone. All right, so everything's working. Go ahead and log off. So that is how you upgrade to .NET 0.6. So guys, so if you guys have any more questions or anything particular, you can always send me a message. And also here, I will leave, I'll share this link here on the bottom of the video, how to migrate your ASP.NET core from 5.0 to 6.0. So, I mean, it tells you here pretty much everything, how to do it, how to upgrade it, how it tells you that they're using this hosting model. So it's supposed to be lighter, faster. So it says no hidden reflections in the use and startup class. A synchronous code can be written because the developer controls the startup. So it has pretty much everything. And it tells you here how to go from 3.0 to or 5.0 Razor Pages templates. All right, so let me see, make sure I have everything done. Oh, actually, I got one more thing I'm supposed to do. Give me one. Let me click. So next, this I forgot to do. So if we build it, actually, let's take a look. That is supposed to give you, I think, let me open this class here. Let me do app users. Let me see. See how it gives you the green line underline. So that's supposed to do that. That's in the new one. So I notice every application has that. And that is what's supposed to do. So if you put that nutable enable, so that's what it's supposed to do. All right, but anyways, that's it, guys. I mean, it's working. That's how you actually migrate from .NET 0.5 to 6. And you probably can do the same thing for 6 to 7 like that. But anyways, guys, I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. And don't forget to subscribe. Take care, guys.